Hello there.
We're Black Beacon Sound.
And this is Dig Deep.
We're here today to set the DJs a challenge of 1 hour to dig through the crates,
1 hour to prepare a mix,
and 1 hour to lay it down. And today we're at the wonderful Alder Bar here in Kelham Island, Sheffield. The stock's unpacked, the kit's ready, the decks are set up. Let's see who's inside.
Hi, I'm Angela. I'm a resident with Crucial Youth Sound System and I'm here today to do the Dig Deep Challenge.
So yeah, obviously welcome Angela to Dig Deep, thanks for coming down. I know you've got a great record just to line up here already that I've noticed, and you've been building a selection all afternoon. Have you found digging in the crates and all that nonsense?
Yeah, an eye-opener, because when it's someone else's records that you don't know it, you're going in blind, aren't you? But yeah. I sort of stuck to what I feel comfortable with. Started off with actually this record, Herb Albert, which is the first record that I ever played for Crucial Youth. So Crucial Youth, I'm a resident with them, so
yeah.
So that's the first record I played, so that's very, very close to my heart, that record.
That record then set the tone for the rest of the mix? Like, was it led by BPM or just sound or style?
Yeah, it's because it's very slow tempo and it's lots of sort of percussion and stuff on it. So you can go anywhere with it because it's very slow. So. Well, this one, again, a favourite of mine. It's on Shade Leaf, it's Pete Simpson singing. And it's just the most soulful track you could ever wish to hear. His vocal is like butter, it's gorgeous.
Is it like sort of soul kind of sits in you from an early age?
Yeah, definitely. That's what got me. I used to listen to sort of Robbie Vincent back in the day and the Todayers and things like that.
Yeah.
My record collection was really soul, funk, disco, and then I discovered electro, which I love.
I mean, is that because you played records from a younger age?
Or you just built records.
You've stuck to it, you haven't crossed over?
No, I'm really struggling with that bit. I don't know if I can.
Struggling with crossing over, yeah.
It's just that whole experience of picking up a record. I know one day I'll probably have to do it, but for the moment, I'm sticking with records.
And on a slightly more serious note, I mean, is the record industry like real wax and vinyl, like, is it oversaturated, do you think, at the minute? There's been this sort of resurgence, especially the last sort of 5 years, maybe.
There's lots of sort of edits of things coming out, and I'm not a great lover of edits, purely because I know all the originals, and it just feels a little bit watered down to me. But there are good edits out there, I'm not saying that all of them are bad, but I do stick to the original stuff a lot. I think I've got two edits, so I've kind of tried to put some edits in there today.
Sweet.
Just to keep it a bit different to what I normally do.
So overall, what can we expect from the mix then?
Pretty soulful, disco, and a little bit house at the end. A few instrumentals in there. It changes, yeah. Okay. Not too drastic, but it changes, yeah.
Well, I'm buzzing, and obviously thanks again for joining and getting on board with this. I'm really excited, so let's get you on the deck.
Okay.
Here we go.
Okay, let's go.
Good evening, yes, this is the Black Beacon Sound, this is the Annoying Challenge.
More difficult than I thought doing it, definitely. When you don't know the record, it's definitely more difficult. Went on a completely different route to what I thought I would. Ended up with Banging House, which I never thought I'd do. It went quicker than I thought. Yeah, I thought I was on a bit of a lane, actually. I thought I stayed on a bit of a disco-y, sort of instrumentally lane a bit, and I think I would have liked to have changed it a bit. I tried to look for some like left field stuff, but I couldn't find any, so I wanted to break it up with a bit of that, but it went well.
What was your
favourite vinyl of the night?
It's got to be Herb Albert. Yeah, Herb Albert. Oh yeah, definitely do again. Yeah. Some more women to come forward, because there haven't been many women coming forward. So come on, girls, let's see what you've got.